Hi, my name is Emma Gardner, and I am the STEM specialist here at WVU Jackson's Mill, and today we are going to learn about beak tools. They say the early bird catches the worm, but not all birds eat worm. The hummingbird, for instance, drinks nectar from a flower while a pelican scoops up fish in the sea. Have you ever thought about how bird beaks have adapted to their food sources? An adaptation is a characteristic of a living thing that helps it live in its habitat. A habitat is the place where living things naturally live and grow. Today, we are going to be engineers by using the engineer design process to design adaptations in the form of bird beaks. An engineer is a person who uses their knowledge of math and science to solve problems. The engineer design process is a five-step cycle. Let's take a look. Up here at the top, we have ask, where you ask a question about how to solve your problem. The next step is imagine, where you imagine your solution. After that, we have plan, where you actually write out your plan and you determine what steps you're gonna take. After that, you create a prototype and you test it. No invention works perfectly the first time. So sometimes you have to move to the next step, which is to improve your design. You do this by asking a question. What can I change about my prototype to make it work better? And then the whole process starts again. And that is our engineer design process. For today's activity, we are going to use the engineer design process to test different tools that are going to represent tools of our beaks along with different food sources. So we are going to test tongs, chopsticks, a spoon, a pipette, and tweezers. So these are our beak tools that we're going to be testing. Our food sources are seeds, in this case I used popcorn kernels, rice, pipe cleaners that are supposed to represent our worms, pom-poms, some kind of drink or juice or food coloring. In our engineering design process, the question that we are asking here is which beak tool works best with which food source? So the next step is to imagine. So let's look at our tools and look at our food sources and really think about which tool will work best to pick up which food source. And some of these tools might work on multiple food sources. So let's think about that. Some things to consider. Will you be picking up multiple items, or will you be picking up a single kernel or a single grain of rice? Will you be trying to scoop up all of your juice or drink, or will you be trying to take a few drops? These are the sort of things that you need to be considering during the imagine step. After imagining, we are going to plan. Now, you can do this on a sheet of paper if you want, or you can use the worksheet that we developed. Here I have my worksheet. So I am going to assign at least one, if not multiple tools, to each of our food sources. You can either write out your plan or you can draw it. I think I'm gonna draw a picture. So I have my plan, but another thing to look at is to consider if each one of our food sources can be picked up by each one of our beak tools. So I'm gonna think about this and predict whether or not they can be picked up or not. I made my predictions and we're gonna see if they were correct or not. So let's get testing. And what you can do is you can either systematically test or you can try choosing the specific design and choice that you made and testing from there. I am going to test one at a time down the line here. So we're gonna start with the tweezers. Now I said for the tweezers that it would definitely be able to pick up the rice. That's the only one that I drew a picture of it for in my plan. But flipping over, I think I said it could pick up a few more things. So let's see. And we'll see if I was correct or not. So we're gonna start with a popcorn kernel. Oh no. It cannot, these tweezers, oh nope, okay. It could barely pick up with a popcorn kernel, but it was hard to do. Let's try a grain of rice. Well, that was easy. Let's try a worm. That was really easy. Now let's try one of these pom-poms. It's a little hard to pick up, but I think I can do it if I pick it up by some hairs. That was hard to do. Do you think a bird with this beak size would be able to eat something like this, much less pick it up? I don't know. And finally, our drink, which it's can pick up maybe a few drops, but it doesn't do very well. Next is our pipette. So let's see if I can pick up any of our popcorn kernels. I think that's a no. What about our rice? Let's see if I can balance it on there. Nope, that's a no too. Now I think maybe I can pick up a worm. I'm very careful. Oh, I got two there. And let's see about a pom-pom. I think that's a no. And finally, our drink. I can definitely pick up. Now, let's test the spoon. Can I pick up the popcorn kernels? I can. What about the rice? Definitely. Now, one thing to think about, I can definitely pick it up while there is a stack here, but can I pick it up when there are just a few grains? Let's see. Nope. What about the popcorn kernel? Nope. So something to think about. Can I pick up a worm? Ooh, not very well. I might be able to do it if I really tried and balanced. There we go, but I have to pick up a lot. I don't think I could pick up one by itself. Let's try one of the pom-poms. Ooh, I can pick one up for the pom-poms. Now it's time for our drink, and let's see. I can scoop it up just like soup. Now our chopsticks. I'm not the best at holding chopsticks. I have some practice from eating sushi, but I'm not always perfect at it, and you may need to work at it too. If you have to hold it a different way, that is quite all right. So let's see if I can pick up popcorn kernel. Ooh, I did it. I'm very impressed. Now how about some rice? Let's see. I did manage to pick up some rice, though it was difficult. What do you think about our worms? Oh, definitely can pick up our worms. And can easily pick up a pom-pom. Now what about our drink? I mean, we got a couple drops on there. I don't know if that counts or not. I definitely dyed my chopsticks red. Finally, we have tongs. So let's see what the tongs can pick up. Ooh, it can pick up our popcorn kernels. It can pick up our rice, whoops. It can pick up our worms. It can pick up our pom-poms. And it really does not do a good job picking up our liquid. All right, so now that we have tested everything, you could improve your design by making your own design using found objects if you wanted, and try to determine what would be the best beak shape and what adaptations you would want to match your food source. We definitely noticed that some of our beak tools worked better than others with particular materials, right? So our pipette for sure worked better with our liquid than even our spoon, and definitely better than any of our other beak tools, right? So let's think a little bit about what these beak tools might represent for our real animals out in the wild. So we talked about a hummingbird earlier picking up nectar from a flower. Which one of these beak tools do you think best represents a hummingbird, and which one of our food sources might represent nectar? That's right, it's our liquid here. So our liquid and our pipette, right? Because a hummingbird has a very small needle-like beak, and it sucks up the nectar. So this represents a hummingbird. Now, we were talking a little bit about a pelican earlier, and I know that they hunt fish in the sea and they scoop them up with their beak. Which one of these beaks do you think best represents a pelican? That's right, the spoon, because it can scoop. We have other examples of good beaks. A bird that might catch a worm might have a beak that is more like our chopsticks or our tong, right? Depending on the size of the bird, or even our tweezers. So these are the sort of things you need to consider while doing this activity. And you can use different beak tools if you like, or you can design your own beak using found objects that you can find around your house or around your neighborhood and try to design a beak of your own. We didn't talk about this earlier, but what food source do you think each one of these represent? So our popcorn kernels could represent seeds. Our rice could represent small bugs. Our pipe cleaners represent worms. Our pom-poms represent larger animals, such as fish or small mammals. And our drink represent nectar. So these are all different representations of the food sources. I hope you enjoyed using the engineer design process to test different beak tools and to decide what kind of beak tools would work best with what food source. Birds have adaptations based on their habitat and their food source. So the way that we think about our beak tools is that they line up with what food source is best for what habitat. Thank you so much.